The most important thing or aspect or characteristic in this paper is the method. The method that it has been used, it has been used in triangulation. Triangulation is a research strategy to validate the information using, on the one hand, quantitative analysis methods, and on the other hand, qualitative analysis methods, and proof that both methods lead to the same results without making mistakes of interpretation. This process is called multi-method approach, and it has been used in the research that we are presenting here. The main objective in this research is identify models of adoption of infocommunication technology in university teaching, and the specific objectives are identify and define the determinants that influence the intention of implementation of e-learning of infocommunication and technology university professors, establish a theoretical model in which the relationship between the variables involved, intention, attitude toward the behavior, subjective norm, conductual, perceived control, perceived behavioral beliefs, normative beliefs, and beliefs of control, and its effect on the intended use of defined e-learning. And finally, analyze phases of adoption. This research is based on the technology acceptance model. This model gives great importance to two aspects that exert a high influence on the expectation and perception that each person has regarding the action that he or she performs. These two aspects are attitude towards behavior and subject standard. But above all, it suggests that there is a causal relationship between the perceived usefulness as to use the methodology and technology will help to improve his academic and professional performance, and the second variable is perceived ease of use, like the use of the technology will entail less effort on his or her part. In our proposal, we evaluate using a multi-method approach university teachers' intention to use e-learning. To that end, we have analyzed different variables such as social image, like professional, social standard, facilitating conditions, perceived ease of use, perceived usefulness, intended use, and e-learning use. Our study used a non-experimental design or expose factor because we study natural groups and teachers from the University of Castilla y León. In particular, we have made a descriptive study to reach a comparative causal model that seeks to discover relationships between variable cause and effect. In this research, we have studied two variables. One of them, it's about identification data, or identification data and sociodemographic characteristics, and the other one is about the variables of the model proposed. All of them have been measured with Likert type scale. To carry out data collection, we have made a sampling stratified by clusters, with the primary units of sampling, universities, and secondary units, faculties selected on a proportional and random roads and sex quote. The straits were formed based on the following five areas of knowledge: art and humanities science, health science, social science and law, and architecture and engineering. The sample size was 445 practicing university teaching from public universities in the Castilla and León, Salamanca, Valladolid, Burgos, and León. Questionnaires were applied through a personal interview in the teacher's offices. And on the other hand, we did 56 spending interviews for qualitative analysis. In the quantitative analysis, first of all, we use a descriptive analysis. Secondly, we carry out confirmatory factor analysis to ensure internal consistency on the unidimensionality of the states. And in the third place, we did a causal analysis in accordance with the structural equation modeling approach with parameter estimation using the maximum likelihood method. For this purpose, we use of the AMOS statistical technique. The results show that teachers attach great importance to variables such as social image, social norm, and perceived usefulness. In other words, teachers' intentions is determined by two factors. On the one hand, the subject's perception of the usefulness, that is, innovation can have in improving his or her teaching practice. And on the other hand, the existence of favorable conditions, the human and technical resources, and equipment available at the university. This result is very interesting because it shows that in a highly professionalized context such as the university, the perception of effort that can come with the introduction of an innovation does not play a significant conditioning role at the home of assuming or incorporating use of that new teaching element. In the same way, if we analyze the teacher discourse, we can see that we get the same relevant ideas as those described previously in the quantitative analysis. To this end, we present the content according to the phases described in Rogers' innovation decision model: knowledge, attitude, decision, application of the innovation, and integration. Category one, knowledge. Like learning about the be-learning innovation, among teachers who are training themselves in be-learning, almost half are teachers in the social science and humanities, compared to nearly a third who are in science. Category two, attitude, like configuration of a positive or negative attitude towards the be-learning innovation, where the majority of those who have undergone training in it have a positive attitude toward building methodology. Category three, decision, like intention to use e-learning, where the majority of the teachers interviewed have the intention to apply e-learning in a short space of time. Very few say that they do not. Here also a main cause of motivation appears to be training in B-learning research. Differences are established according to sex. Female teachers express it to a greater extent an intention to use B-learning relative to male teachers. Category four, application of the innovation, like regular use of B-learning. a high number of teachers stated that they had undertaken a teaching activity in which in-person class activities were combined with online activities and vice versa. Category 5, integration, like creative application and generalization to the different contexts. Almost the half of the teachers have advantage proficiency in e-learning that allows them to execute a creative use of it and apply it in any type of teaching context. The reason that best classifies subjects in this space is prior training in e-learning. And the conclusions, both the qualitative and quantitative methodology have shown that performance expectancy is the most powerful category with regard to intention to use the e-learning system among the university teachers. Second, the most part intention to use e-learning comes about through teachers' positive perception with regard to the academic results that can be obtained when this methodology is applied in their classes. And finally, in contrast, the effect of the effort expectancy construct is notably weak or ineffective in relation to intention to use e-learning, both in the general model and as analyzed in the different subgroups according to individual characteristics. It's very likely that the type and profile of the sample explain the absence of effect of this factor. Thank you very much.